de seguro.
We don't have any, you know, any insurance.
Tampoco este, no agua.
We don't have water.
No hay break.
There aren't breaks.
Más quieren trabajo, trabajo y trabajo.
They just want work, work, and work.
Uno tiene que hacer caso.
And you know, you have to heed what they say.
Y tenemos que seguir, si no, nos corren.
And we have to continue working, otherwise they'll fire us. They'll kick us out.
Ahora decidimos salir para huelga a ver si cambian las cosas.
Now we decided to go on strike to see if they'll finally change conditions.
A ver qué podemos hacer para la otra gente que quedó ahí.
Now figuring out what else can we do for the people who are still there.
A ver si nos dan de perder unos cuantos beneficios.
You know, to see if, you know, they give us some benefits.
Y a ver qué cambia.
And, you know, figuring out, you know, making it so that they change.
Yeah, amen, brother.
Mi nombre es Jorge Valderas.
My name is Jorge Valderas.
Estoy aquí también por mi compañero.
I'm, you know, here for the same reasons my compañero has just said.
Una de las razones por las cuales yo decidí salir a huelga.
One of the reasons I decided to go on strike.
Es porque la compañía de Ambra no tiene, no ofrece ningún beneficio.
It's because the Ambra company doesn't offer any benefits.
No provee el equipo necesario para trabajar, no es de seguridad.
It doesn't provide the security equipment that's necessary to work.
No provee agua.
It doesn't provide water.
Hace unos días yo tuve una experiencia.
Some days ago, something happened to me.
Relacionado a lo de la seguranza.
Related to insurance.
Tengo mi esposa enferma de cáncer.
My wife is sick with cancer.
El hospital me pedía que yo tuviera mi aseguranza.
The hospital asked me for insurance.
Le mandaron una carta notarizada a la compañía.
They sent a notarized letter to the company.
Para que dijera por qué no ofrece aseguranza.
Asking why it doesn't offer insurance.
El proceso tardó más.
The process lasted quite a while.
El cáncer de mi esposa estaba en etapa 4.
My wife's cancer was already in stage 4.
No la pudieron atender por que no le mandaron la carta.
They couldn't give her attention because they didn't send the letter back.
En ese tiempo yo estaba trabajando en Houston.
At that time I was working in Houston.
Tuve que ir personalmente a la oficina.
I had to go personally to the office.
Para que la mandaran.
So that they would send the letter.
Ahorita está, se acabó el plazo de que daban por 6 meses.
Now that 6 month period is over.
Del hospital.
Of the hospital.
Una vez más tuvieron que mandar la carta.
Once again they had to send the letter.
Y no la mandaron.
And they didn't send it.
Si no la mandan, el caso lo van a cerrar la próxima semana.
If they don't send the letter, they're going to close the case in a week.
Entonces este, necesitamos que cambien eso.
We need for them to change that.
Hay muchos trabajadores ahí que a lo mejor están pasando por lo mismo o peor.
There's many workers there who are probably going through the same or even worse.
Es todo por el momento.
That's it for now. O-M-A-R, then last name Rendon, R-E-N-D-O-N.
Alright, thank you. If you have a question, you can just raise your hand and call on me. That would be best. Of course, they're going to support anything.
About the health insurance?
Sobre el seguro médico.
Uh, Are you saying there is health insurance and they're not paying, or is there no health insurance?
Está diciendo que hay seguro médico, pero no lo están pagando, o que no hay seguro médico.
No hay seguro médico.
There isn't any health insurance.
I'm sorry I don't know this, but do y'all have a union? Are you members of a union, and is there any support?
Perdóneme que no sé esto, pero ustedes, hay un sindicato, o son miembros de un sindicato? Esa pregunta. Could you repeat the question?
Do you have a union?
¿Ustedes tienen un sindicato? ¿Son miembros de un sindicato? ¿Tienen apoyo de un sindicato? No, but we don't.
They don't have a union, but the support of the armed forces.
¿Cuál es el nombre de la compañía por la cual ustedes trabajan?
What's the name of the company y'all work for?
The Amber Steel.
The Amber Steel?
I think you're showing a tremendous amount of courage, and I wonder how the rest of us can get behind you. What kind of help can we provide?
Está mostrando un gran valor, y me pregunto cómo nosotros podemos ayudar, cómo podemos contribuir.
Que nos por eso estamos aquí, verdad, para que nos.
That's why we're here.
Grupos como ustedes, vean la manera de cómo nos pueden ayudar.
So that groups like you can, you know, figure out how you can help.
Sería bueno de que alguien se murió en uno de los sitios de trabajo hace la semana pasada o dos semanas, y solamente quería preguntarles más de esas cosas, si es que eran
que están trabajando. ¿Tú escuchaste de alguien?
Sí.
I heard about somebody dying on a job site, some people dying on a job site 1 or 2 weeks ago, and I wanted to know what information y'all have.
The workers' defense people are here, they probably have some figures on deaths in the construction industry.
Yes, we're currently working on a study that looks at that. As a statewide project, there was a preliminary study that Workers' Defense in Austin did that just looked at construction worker conditions in Austin, and we're currently collecting data statewide so that we can have stronger data on that.
Well, nevertheless, most of the deaths in the industry are in construction, and most of the people that die are Latinos.
Yes. Yes, Texas has the highest rate of construction worker deaths in the entire country. I think it's one death every 2 days.
2 days and a half.
Yeah, one death every 2.5 days in Texas.
This company, how big are they? And do they not offer benefits to any employees, or just to your level of employees, or?
Esta compañía, ¿qué tan grande es? ¿Es que no ofrece beneficios a cualquier empleado, o solamente al nivel de empleado al cual ustedes pertenecen?
Ellos, a lo mejor, sí les dan a los supervivientes.
But they may give benefits to superintendents, to the supervisors. But to us, nothing.
And are they aware of that there are laws governing breaks and lunch periods and those kinds of things, federal laws?
¿Y están conscientes de que existen leyes federales que pues requieren descansos y pues diferentes medidas?
Sí, eso estoy de acuerdo, deben de proveer un.
Yes, I mean, from what I understand, they should provide a break at 9 a.m.
Por 8 horas.
For 8 hours.
Pero ahí trabajamos más.
But we work more.
Y no hay break, solamente a las 12.
And, you know, there aren't any breaks, just at noon, just 30 minutes.
Y a veces trabajamos hasta las 10, 11 de la noche.
Sometimes we work until 10, 11 p.m.
Y nomás un descanso a las 12.
And just one break at noon.
That's wrong.
How many employees are there?
¿Cuántos empleados hay?
Donde andamos nosotros son como 10.
When we're working, it's about 10.
About 10 per group?
10 por grupo.
How many of you have gone on strike?
¿Cuántos
just you four, or is there more than you? Or
¿cuántos de ustedes han ido de huelga? For now, it's just me and him.
Yeah, the company has several hundred employees, right, Manny?
They have about 250 employees in there. You asked, you know, how big this company is. Big. They have a shop in El Paso. They have another company in Houston. That's the main branch in Houston. And then they have a subdivision right here in Dallas. Okay, but we don't know exactly where they're at in here.
Well, if they're that big, aren't they required to provide health insurance for employees? And
all the workers that I talked to, they tell me the same thing. So I'm an organizer for the Iron Workers International, okay? And I tell you, okay, they tell me the same thing. There's no breaks, no insurance, no water, and they don't provide no safety equipment to the workers. Those are the main four things that we know.
What has the state said about this? Have you gone to the state? There are state laws, or there should be state laws?
No. Not yet, because I mean, we're not going to jeopardize that these guys, because we were not had any strikers yet. Maybe now we can do something about it in the future.
Poner en peligro a estos muchachos, pero tal vez ahora podemos hacer el...
Cooper, and then back to you, and then.
Yes, have either of you noticed, or even the union organizers as well, noticed that this mistreatment is geared mostly towards immigrant workers, or is it for all sort of lower level construction workers?
¿Alguno de ustedes se ha fijado que este maltrato se ha dirigido más a trabajadores inmigrantes, o es algo que todos los trabajadores experimentan?
Porque pues ahí la mayoría, a lo que yo veo, somos inmigrantes.
The majority of, what I see, were immigrants.
Bueno, gracias. A mí me sorprende que no tenga un tipo de seguridad en el trabajo. It surprises me there is no insurance. Acabamos de hablar sobre las leyes federales y estatales. We just mentioned something about the federal law and state law that is required for a certain number of employers to have insurance. Pero aquí estoy un poco confundido. Bueno, primeramente que nada, yo soy un estudiante en la Universidad de Texas en Dallas. Y yo aprendí mediante el Workers' Defense Project, el proyecto de defensa laboral. So maybe what I wanted to ask you, algo que ya se preguntó también, es de qué es lo que, y quiero que alguien ya lo dijo, qué es lo que quieren que esta organización haga por ustedes. So what do you want this organization to do for you? No sé si puedo dar un ejemplo más concreto en el cual yo tenga algo más de idea, saber cómo yo y también individualmente puedo ayudar. En ya se hace por otro. Por afuera, por otro lado.
Que nos den seguro.
Eso es lo que ustedes quieren, que les den seguro en el trabajo.
They give us insurance. That's what you want. You want them to give you insurance at work.
So, okay, quieren aseguranza y quieres también descansos.
Aseguranza.
You also want breaks.
Descansos.
Insurance. Breaks.
Equipo de.
De seguridad.
De seguridad.
Safety equipment.
Y agua.
And water.
Okay. Muchas gracias.
My question was, have you considered keeping a log day-to-day whenever they do not allow you to take breaks so that later you can file an official complaint with OSHA? Because OSHA does require, if you work more than 4 hours, you get a 15-minute break, more than 6 hours, you get a 15-minute break and a 30-minute lunch, and more than 8 hours, you get two 15-minute breaks and a 30-minute lunch legally. And a similar situation like this was happening.
Let me cut you off there.
Yes, sir.
So, could you Say the first part of your question.
Have you considered taking a log of
hacer un récord de cuando no proveen descansos?
Of every day that you do not get more than one break.
O entre todos los días cuando ustedes no reciben más de un descanso.
So that you can file an official complaint with OSHA.
Para que puedan hacer una queja formal a OSHA. Sí, la pregunta fue si ustedes han considerado tomar un récord de todos los días donde no les proveen descansos para luego hacer una queja formal a OSHA. Y pueden dirigirse a él. La pregunta fue de OSHA.
Lo que pasa es que como nosotros estamos, a veces miedo.
What happens is, you know, fear.
De que yo personalmente sí había pensado.
You know, personally, you know, I had thought that.
En juntarnos,
you know, of, you know, coming together,
o decirles a todos los trabajadores,
you know, telling all the workers,
pero sé que nadie va a hacerlo.
But you know, I know nobody's gonna do it.
Por miedo a perder el trabajo.
You know, for fear of losing work, of losing their job.
Por eso.
It's because of that.
Thank you.
What about workers' comp? Are you all covered with workers' comp?
¿Y qué de la compensación laboral? ¿Ustedes están cubiertos con compensación laboral?
No, when they get hurt, this is what I got, you know, from the workers. Whenever they get hurt,
cuando se lastiman,
I mean, they just mainly take them to a clinic.
Por
they
lo
send
general,
them home.
Lo llevan a una clinica,
when they come back from the clinic, a lot of times, you know, they just terminate the worker.
Cuando regresan de la clínica, terminan el trabajo, terminan el trabajador.
Ahora cuando te lastimas,
when you get injured, when you get hurt,
no vas a trabajar, no se te va a pagar.
No, you can't work and you don't get paid.
En unas ocasiones pues, tienes que pagar tú al doctor.
And you know, in some occasions, some instances, you have to pay yourself the medical bill.
Como dice él,
and like he says,
vas a trabajar, pero en cuanto te recuperas, te corren.
You know, you go to work, but you know, as soon as you recover, they kick you off the site.
Cuando vas al baño, pues luego te dicen, ¿vas al baño otra vez?
You know, when you go to the bathroom, they ask you, you're going to the bathroom again?
A veces tiene que aguantar uno.
And you know, sometimes you gotta hold it.
Y las,
and you know, are those bathrooms, are they clean? Yeah, they're clean.
You're from the United Iron Workers, is that what you said?
Yeah, I'm with United Iron Workers International, and so
I might
see you.
Okay, what steps have you taken so far? Have you looked into these, you know, are these valid, or have you talked to, you know, to the company? What steps have you taken so far?
The first step that we have taken right now is talk to these workers, tell them, you know, that they have, you know, rights.
Decirle que tienen derechos.
We want to help them to get, you know, not only the breaks, but whatever else, you know, they need. Okay? And that's what we would talk to them in gas to go out on strike. Okay, so that's how we help them right now.
So is this their first day?
This is the beginning. This is just the beginning.
This is the first day of the strike?
No, they went on strike on Tuesday.
Have you approached the owners yet?
We send them a letter, certified letter, and tell them that these two guys went on strike.
That's
the first step that we have taken. We're going to go forward
from
now on.
Vamos a seguir hacia adelante ahorita.
Yeah, I just want to make a statement. We went to help those guys go on to strike. I'm a striker myself for another company. Name is Greg Western. So we we went to talk to these guys just 2 days ago, and what we seen in taking pictures, there was a lot of people working there, and there was no water at all. So we take pictures. So next day, I hear one of the workers that talked to one of the superintendents, and Ryan, actually Ryan went to this job site, there was 5 buckets of water. So they take the message that we're not playing, and we're gonna help those guys, like we're trying to help the guys from Great Western to get the benefits, get water in the jobs, especially right now it's gonna be really hot. We don't want those guys to get injured or get degraded.
Can I ask what the pay is? What's the pay scale? What's the pay range?
¿Cuánto es el pago? ¿Cuánto es el cuánto se paga?
Como yo que bueno que estamos más allegados al mayordomo que anda ahí.
But those of us who are closer to the superintendent.
Son 14.50.
It's 14.50.
I'm sorry.
Ellos son menos.
Generalmente lo que está pagando la compañía son $14.
In general, the company pays about $14.
$14. Take this on this comment, and one more if someone has a burning question, then we'll talk a little bit about the action coming up.
En ese momento nos gustaría en nuestras organizaciones que somos de Dallas Brown Brand y Brown brindarles nuestro apoyo en cualquier cosa que necesitan. Si quieren hacer una acción, si van a ir a hacer una protesta, no manches, por favor, cuenten con nosotros. Les ofrecemos nuestro apoyo y también seguridad.
Gracias.
And if you'd like to join us for an action, we're actually we're planning on doing a sort of a delegation. It's going to be a very large delegation today, if all of you are able to join us. But we'll be going to the construction office at Parkland Hospital. Parkland, as you know, is building this huge $1.2 billion hospital in several phases. It's like, you know, maybe halfway through construction. But D'Ambra is on that project. And, you know, there have been a lot of issues there. So the basic objective is to go to the construction office and to notify them that they have some real problems on their site, specifically with D'Ambra Steel. And, you know, Jorge and Omar are going to tell a little bit about their stories, you know, to the project manager there at Parkland, if he's willing to meet with us. I've got directions to the office on this table here in front of Adrian. It's actually directions are to a parking lot at a church across from the office that should have plenty of spaces. So we'll meet there, and then we'll head across the street to this office and let them know what's up. But thank you for sticking with us, hearing their stories, and joining us in a few minutes.
You know what?